And he gets under this one, and in fact breaks his bat as this one's popped up. And he'll avoid the fragments out there to make the catch that ends the inning. One left for the Yankees. Score remains tied 1-1. Carlos Gomez, ready to take another shot, went down on strikes his last time up.
Carlos Gomez.
Here it comes. Too high that time with the inning's first pitch. Hits ball one. This man out for a second inning of work, and why not? He set him down 1-2-3 the last time around.
Right, and with two strikeouts mixed in there as well. Just let him keep going.
Now here it comes. And Gomez not biting on that one either. It's 2-0 now. And this pitch is inside, and he can't find the zone all of a sudden. 3-0.
And this is just a guy that's going to be happy to take a walk, so I'm a little bit surprised that they haven't challenged him a little bit more from the mound.
And the pitch. And he lays off. Ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here.
Well, and here in extra innings, you just need one little spark, something that can get you going. And we've seen a leadoff walk to be the difference in a ball game more times than once. So they need to take advantage of this.
Carlos Correa will step in, a ground-out victim his last time. Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. And this pitch is taken on the inner half for strike one.
And that's what he needed to do after the four-pitch walk. Come right back and get ahead versus the next guy.
And this is fouled back and out of play. Go-ahead runs aboard here at first with nobody out. Now here's a ball hit high and deep out to left center field. Hicks is in retreat as he pulls it in for the first down. Evan Gattis strides in, grounded out his last time through. Here's the first pitch, and a pitch out, nothing doing though, and that's ball one. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. And another snap throw to the bag. Keeping particularly close tabs on him. Downstairs, two balls and no strikes. Now a snap move over to first, and he's back easily. Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Now a swing as he hits this one into the air. This will be foul, off to the right, out of play. Foul back. Struck him out as his woes continue, as that's his third strikeout of the game.
Oh, that's a nice comeback from down in the count, 2-0. He doesn't panic. He doesn't just start laying pitches in there. He had a good plan to start with, and then he executed that plan all the way through the at-bat.
Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. Stepping in now, Colby Rasmus. A pitch out. The throw. And they'll nail him at second on a brilliant call to pitch out, and the inning is over. Astros are down quietly. Still tied one apiece. Starlin Castro steps in to get the home side started here in the 10th. And now pitch on the way. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. Pitch on the way. Good waste pitch, 1-2. Now a swing and a miss as Castro is retired here for the first down.
He's put together two spotless innings so far out of the bullpen. And I think a third would be above and beyond the call here.
Chase Headley will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Now here's the pitch. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball. One out, nobody on. A late swing here as this is hit hard to the right side. And a backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down.
There you go. Now that potential winning run is on at first base. I don't think they'll try to bunt him over here either. Not with one out already. They'll be open for a gapper to try and end this right here, right now.
Didi Gregorius gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. Here's the first pitch. And he turns on this one and yanks it foul and back out of play. Possible winning run on first, one man away. Now a fastball off the plate away, a ball and a strike. A look at the hit totals there into extra innings. The 1-1 pitch. This ball is grounded foul. Slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. Possible winning run on first, one man away. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
And this is where the scouting report really pays off. I mean, sometimes you just got to go looking for a soft spot in the guy's zone, and they found one there.
Into the box now, Aaron Hicks, as he'll take a changeup here for strike one. Swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. Stassi is there to make the catch, and that means we've got more baseball ahead. The Yanks leave one. Score. Score remains deadlocked at one. Colby Rasmus comes to the plate as the leadoff man here in the 11th inning.
Colby Rasmus.
Now the pitch. And a fastball for Miller as he jumps ahead, nothing and one. Now here's the pitch. Oh, and a good tight slider there. He's in command, nothing and two.
And not only two, I'd be shocked to see another fastball in the strike zone.
And he starts to go after it. Question was, did he hold up in time? Yes, indeed, says the third base umpire. Here's the pitch. Here's a fastball in on the fist, and that'll even things up at 2-2. Now the pitch. A full count, three balls and two strikes. George Springer waits on deck. Swing and a miss as he couldn't connect on the two-seamer, and that's at number one.
Wow, you know, neither team really seems to want to take command of this ballgame. I mean, this is ripe for the picking. Yeah, guys are just not coming up with good at-bats right now.
George Springer stands in, reached on a walk in his last trip. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
This fastball is looking pretty lively right now.
Outside at 94, one ball and one strike. And he lays off this one down and in for ball two. And now pitch on the way. And this is going to be a foul ball. And the pitch. And it gets under the 2-2 a bit as this is sent in the air out to straightaway central. And Hicks will settle under this one for the second out.
Two quick outs here to start things off. Can't ask for much more than this in extra innings. Hold, serve, and give your guys a shot to win in the bottom half.
Luis Valbuena will stand in. He flew out his last time up. The pitch. Below the knees, one ball, no strikes. Two out, nobody on. And he fires in a strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. Look into McCann, the 1-1. And here's a ball hit in the air. Teixeira will range over to make the catch just beyond the first base dugout, and that will end the inning. Astros go down 1-2-3. Score remains tied 1-1.
Your
Luke Gregerson will take over now to start the home 11, knowing that just one would be the end of this ball game. Brett Gardner is set to take some more swings. He homered back in the third inning. Landed in on the fists, nothing in one. And a hard sinker there, chopped foul at home plate. Pitch on the way. And a pitch down that swung on and sent to second base. Throw on to first in time, one away. Carlos Beltran stands into the box. He could really use the knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. And this one's chopped foul right at home plate. And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time. He's falling behind now, 3-1.
And like most guys, the further ahead in the count he gets, the more dangerous he becomes. He's going to lock in on one pitch, one zone, and he'll hurt you if he guesses right.
Now here's the pitch. Fouled straight back. Bases are empty, one man out. And he lays off ball four. So now the potential winning run is aboard at first.
That's a good at-bat. And sometimes in extra innings, guys start to chase because they're getting tired and frustrated. They're looking for one big hit. That's not the case here.
Now time is called, and a very wise decision here with the potential winning run at first. They'll opt to put a little extra speed on the base pass. Alex Rodriguez will step forward now following the walk as he'll hit with a definite speed threat at first and one away.
You can bet he's going to see some fastballs in this at-bat. I'd be looking dead red.
For the pitch, a check on that winning run at first. And he'll dive back in safely. Runner goes for second. A pitch out. The throw.
And you know what, guys? That could turn out to be the most important play of this game so far. They roll the dice and send him with one away. But he's in there safely. And now you've got all sorts of opportunities to end this thing with a base hit.
Possible game winners at second base here with one away. Swung on and missed, 1-1.
And in this spot, you got to pitch for the strikeout here. And this is a guy that's gone down twice so far. So you have that in your favor.
And he misses, 2-1. Working away pretty much exclusively here so far.
And I don't think they're doing it to set up anything on the inside part of the plate. I doubt they're going to give him anything to pull.
Now the 2-1. And the runner's breaking for third. Pitch misses low. The throw down. Not in time as he just gets in ahead of the throw.
That right there is about as nutty a decision as I've ever seen. I mean, you're the winning run.
you're already in scoring position. It's going to wind up working out, but that can't have come from the bench. He had to do that one on his own.
So there's ball four. And it wouldn't surprise me a bit to see the next guy get four wide ones as well.
All right, now with one out, they'll set up a possible double play. But also, you still got the go-ahead run in third, so you need to be sure that you can get two if you try in the middle.
Mark Teixeira will stand in now, hitless to this point, but with a chance to be a hero here.
Well, he knows better than anybody in that lineup that one swing could make up for a whole game's worth of struggles.
First pitch on its way to Teixeira. In there to strike one.
That's not a bad idea right there. Take a pitch. Make sure you get a good look at him and what he's throwing.
Possible winning run just 90 feet away here. One away. Check swing, but he held up in time. Ball one. Coming home. Now a little dribbler up the line to first. And the Yankees are going to walk off as winners.
Well, you had the sense early on that this one was destined to go down to the wire. And sure enough, these guys are going to pull this one out here in walk-off fashion.
Offense was led in large part by this man, Brett Gardner. Don't put that card in your bicycle spokes. He's our top player of the game.
You have to feel good for that guy right there. The games finally count, and he comes out on opening day and turns in a great performance. That's how you want to get your season started.
It's bad business. You got me tied up in knots, strung up like a dog. Bad business, yeah.
So that'll just about do it for us this afternoon. Thanks to Eric Carroll, Steve Lyons, and the rest of our crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. Find out more, head on over to theshownation.com. The Yankees come out on top, 2-1. So long from the Bronx.
Our final line score this afternoon, first for the victorious Yankees, 2 runs on 4 hits. No errors, 3 left, 5 down. For the Astros, 1 run, 5 hits. No errors, 10 down. The winning pitcher is Andrew Miller. His record is now 1-0. Oscar's record, he falls to 4. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 33 minutes. Thank you for attending. And remind you, please,
doing it, you rather ruin it. I'm too legit, go hammer with the foolishness. My nana said my grammar can maneuver this industry until I'm stupid rich, and now I'm stupid rich. Ah! Assuming this is more than humorous, the butterfly, my newest shit. In fact, the rumor is the way I prove it.
I'm a classic man. You can be me when you look this clean. I'm a classic man. Calling on me like a young OG. I'm a classic man. Your knees get met by the street. Elegant, old-fashioned man. Yeah, baby, I'm a classic man. I burn through the hood like war. When everybody feeling so cold. Cherish it. I know how to decorate your wall and further furnish it. I'ma burn your down, this is where the furnace is. I'ma turn your around with some friendly services. Ain't no nervousness, like I'm wretched, no conservative, and that's affirmative. All I do is lay up and face up my big bills and paste up. Got no chill for fake ones, like for real, they say I'm a classic man. You can be mean when you look this clean. I'm a classic man.